Portrait de la jeune fille en feu.
Take a look at yourself. Beautiful.
Instead of being an absorbed spectator, a voyeuristic spectator, a male spectator, as it were, I suddenly found I'd become a woman spectator who watched the film from a distance and critically, rather than with those absorbed eyes.
À vous. Vous trichez?
Mais non, je ne triche pas. Je joue vite.
I wasn't sure you'd come.
I really built my character as a journey between so being an object to being a subject.
On set and even at the audition, I had this sensation like Celine was really creating this environment of, you know, kindness and collaboration, this horizontal gaze between all of us. And as an actor, we were not just object, we were a part of this creation. And to be part of this creation is to give us a space to express and to propose things.
Would you like to come visit me this Sunday?
Yes.
What a strange girl you are.
Why?
Flung out of space.
Both characters do, they're quite isolated. Not only because, you know, their feelings for one another sort of set them apart from the worlds in which they inhabit, but, you know, the gap in their ages and, you know, they go through a lot of processing these volcanic feelings independent of one another.
Phyllis had a really difficult job at adapting something like that, because how can you, you know, unless you have voiceover throughout the entire film, it's hard to be in someone's head like that. And so she brilliantly changed, in the book, Therese is a stage designer, and in the film, she's a photographer. And so that really sort of added this way into her mind, because you get to, you know, she sees the world in a very visual way as a photographer. And also, you know, it the script did have sort of all these like flashes of details.
Vous ne dites rien?
C'est moi?
Oui.
Vous me voyez comme ça? Cette fois-ci, je l'aime bien.
Peut-être parce que je vous connais un peu mieux.
Peut-être que j'ai changé aussi depuis.
Peut-être, oui.
From the beginning of the movie, I know I am looked at. I think it's different for the character of Marianne, who is ignoring the fact that she's being looked at also, you know. So it's more, to me, it's a turning point in a direction that I become really a subject, but Marianne, like, notice at that point that she's also an object in my eyes, you know.
Thank you. Oh, God, don't. I look a fright.
You do not. You look wonderful. Just stay like that.
Do you miss Richard?
No, I haven't thought about him all day.
The camera is so great at being objective or subjective, and so you were very clear about whose perspective the camera was catching.
I was looking very closely at love stories on film and how they function and how much point of view is how we remember great love stories when we're anchored with a certain character, usually the more vulnerable character in the relationship. And what's so interesting about Carol is that shifts. It begins when we're sort of looking at Carol through Therese's eyes. And by the end of the film, a lot has changed, and both of these women have undergone tremendous changes. And then it's Carol who reevaluates the extraordinary value of this young woman in her life and what that meant and how rare that is. And she comes back and, you know, invites Therese into her life. But of course, Therese, because she's weathered, you know, pain and develop defenses like we all do as we grow up, is no longer that same person.
One of the manifestos of the film is actually to get rid of this idea of the muse, which is a nice word that actually hides the participation of women in art history. The muse is this fetishized, silent woman who's inspiring just because she's beautiful. And we know that even though for a long time women opportunity were to be models. These models were in the room, they were co-creating, they were part of, they were one of the brain in the room.
I don't know. I mean, I think in a lot of relationships, hopefully there's an equal amount of giving and receiving going on. I mean, I definitely feel as though Therese got so much from Carol, but I like to think Carol got something from her as well. I don't.
It's something we've missed. It's a female gaze. And female gaze is what it's something we need more. It's our story, our stories, and this film is all about that. It's all about love and all about art and all about sorority also. And I was, this is important.